This is an American toad. At least I think it's an American toad. It's pretty hard to tell the difference between American Fowlers and Oak in the state of North Carolina. However, what I can tell you is he's definitely a male. Because one, he's calling, and two, he's got that little blue throat. Both of those things tell you that he is a male. You can also look at the size of him. This guy's actually going through shed right now. I just peeled a small bit of his shed off. They shed that skin off themselves just like reptiles would. However, they end up actually eating it as a way to recycle the nutrients. He is a very grumpy little thing, and I found him in an area that's actually not gonna be here too much longer. Because this is a lot for a house. I'm not sure if this specific lot has sold yet, but it's definitely going to be developed within his lifetime. So I'm going to relocate him to some public game lands. But before that, I'm going to keep looking around for some other things. So here's something I learned from Chris Ignato, which is a very underrated YouTube channel, and it's really hard to film the stuff so you can't see most of it, but there's all this stuff in the water which looks like oil, like maybe it's from a car or something, and I never actually knew what it was. I assumed that's what it was, but it turns out that it's a naturally occurring vegetable sort of oil that basically just comes from the dead plant matter in the area. So it definitely makes me feel better to know that all of this oily stuff I've been seeing over the past few years, which I thought was like artificial man-made stuff, or not man-made, but man put here, but instead it's actually naturally occurring here and won't mess up anything in the environment. When I try relocating animals and they have no idea what's going on, no matter what I'm trying to do with them, they clearly just completely freak out. If I could just tell them, like, your home is about to be, like, destroyed, and I can give them a few minutes to just let it soak in, then a few minutes later I can just be like, okay, I'm gonna guide you to a new area, it's gonna be really nice, a lot more space, a lot safer, maybe find some mates, but no, they have to make it all difficult. So we are in game lands now. You saw me cross that river, or I guess more of a like little creek bed or stream. The reason I did that, both sides are game lands, but that side is way closer to a neighborhood, and you saw how difficult it was for me to get across it, so I'm pretty sure he won't be able to cross that, so he should be good in this area. I'm right here by this big dead tree. He has some spaces to hide, some nice water sources right around here, so he should be good to go. Right in this area, which I've honestly never seen in the wild. I've never actually caught an actual developed newt either, so this is really interesting to see. Hopefully you can see a couple of them, but they are so quick to get under all this muddy leafy brush. Oop, got it. I don't know what type of newt this is, but you can see him right there. Let's give him some water. I don't know how long they can go without water.